This is another practice video, this time to convert fractions into decimals. So if you could pause your video, copy down these questions, try them yourselves, and once you've finished, start up again, and you can follow along how I do them and see if you get the same answers that I get. Now, the first line is fairly easy. We start out and we write down the number and, need a pencil to do that. Write down the number, and we want as many numbers after the decimal point as there are zeros in the bottom number, the denominator. So we need to have one number after the decimal point, and often write a zero in front of the decimal point just to draw attention to the decimal point. Now here we have a 7, and we want, there's two zeros in the denominator, so we want to have two numbers after the decimal point, or we only have one here, so we have to write a 0 so that we have two numbers after the decimal point. And again, I'm going to write a 0 in front of the decimal point, so this would be not point, not 7. Now here we have 131, and there's three zeros in the denominator, so we want to have three numbers at the decimal point. Well, we do have three numbers here, so we just write the decimal point in front of it, and a 0 in front just to let us know that the decimal point's there. Now here we have 11 thousandths. Write down the 11, and there's three numbers off the decimal point, so I have to put another 0 in front of the 11 so that I can have three numbers off the decimal point and a 0 in front. Now, the rest of these, I first have to change these into numbers with either a 10, 100, 1,000, or some number with 1 and zeros after it for the denominator. So this is 18/50. If I multiply the top and bottom by 2, I change this into so many hundredths. That's supposed to be a 2. And I get 36 hundredths, which as a decimal we would write like this. There are two zeros after the 1 in the denominator, so there need to be two numbers after the decimal point. Now this converts to 41 hundredths, so as a decimal we write 40, and two numbers after the decimal point. Now the 0 after the whole number here doesn't really change things a whole lot. We could just write that as 0.4. Putting a 0 in front, just as I said, let us know that there's a decimal there. This next one, to change 20 into 100, I multiply by 5. I have to multiply the top by 5, giving us 100 on the bottom, 35 on the top. So I write down 35. There's two numbers, two zeros in the bottom of the fraction, so I need two numbers after the decimal point. Now to change 25 into 100, I multiply by 4. I have to multiply the top by 4 as well. And let's see, 4 times 17 would be 28 and 40, 68. And I write the 68, and I need two numbers after the decimal point. Okay, now here I can turn 5 into a number with 1 and and zeros just by multiplying by 2 to get 10. And if I multiply the top by 2 as well, I get 8 over 10. And I convert that by writing the 8. And I just need one number after the decimal point because there's one zero on the bottom. Now this one, 4/10 already has a 10 on the bottom, so I just need to write the 4. And I need one number after the decimal point because there's one zero in the bottom number. Now 3/4, I can't multiply 4 by anything to get 10, but if I multiply it by 25, I get 100. And I have to multiply the top by the same number to have an equivalent fraction. It gives 75/100, and we write down the 75. And we need two numbers after the decimal point because there's two zeros in the denominator. Now half, I can multiply by 5, the top and bottom by 5, and get 5/10. And to write that as a decimal, I write down the top number, and I need one number after the decimal point. Now, here's an interesting one, 8. I can't multiply 8 by anything to get 10, not any, a whole number anyway, and I can't multiply 8 by anything to get 100. But if I multiply 8 by 125, and I know this from years of experience, and this is a little trick that you need to remember, that 8 times 125 is 1,000. So I need to multiply the top and bottom of this fraction by 125. And I get that 1/8 is the same as 125/1,000. Now to write that as a decimal, I write down the 125, and I need three numbers after the decimal point. There's 1, 2, 3, so I put the decimal point in front, and I put the zero. And here I have another fraction with 8 on the bottom. I multiply top and bottom by 125 again, and I get 1,000 on the bottom, and I happen to know that 3 times 100 is 300, 3 times 25 is 75, so this is 375/1,000, which we would write not 0.375, there's 3 zeros on the bottom, so it needs to be 3 numbers after the decimal point. Now we come to some other interesting fractions here. 1/3. Now there's nothing you can multiply 3 by to get 10 or 100 or 1,000 or any number with 1 and the zeros in front. So with this we have to resort to a different method of converting the fraction. And it's dividing the top number by the bottom number. Now, I could do this, so I have some room off to the side here, just a little bit. I'll try it in here. 1 divided by 3. 3 doesn't go into 1, so it goes 0, and then we can put in our decimal point here and here, and now it's 3 into 10 goes 3 times, and 3 times 3 is 9, subtract 9 from the 10 and we get 1, bring down another 0, and we're dividing 3 into 10 again. And 3 times 3 is 9, and I think you can see that this process is going to continue. We're just going to get continuing 3's. So this method of dividing the top number by the bottom number works no matter what fraction you have. It would have worked on all these questions up here, but there was another way to do them that is possibly easier, unless you have a calculator. And if you have a calculator, calculator is almost always easier than this method here, but it's good to know this method in case you don't have a calculator and it's a bit easier. Now here I have 2/3, and again, if I divide 2 by 3, I can get the answer, and instead of working it out, I do have a calculator here, and I can do 2 divided by 3 equals, and you see it's repeating 6's, and that shouldn't surprise anyone, because 2/3 is just going to be double 1/3, and this is repeating 3, so this is repeating 6's. Now, I should indicate it here. When you have a repeating decimal point, repeating decimal, you can indicate it by dot, 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 or just put a dot over the number. That means it repeats that many times, and we can put the dot there. It means those 6's are going to continue to repeat. Now here I have 1/9, and again, well, all these questions on the last row, we cannot convert to the bottom number to a 10 or 100 or 1,000, so we're going to have to use a calculator again. Now, you might know that 1/9 is 1/3 of 1/3, so we might think that the repeating decimal for 1/9 is going to be 1/3 of 0.333, which would be not 0.111, and repeating. And just to confirm it on the calculator, we do 1 divided by 9 equals repeating 1's. We can also write that just to one place with a dot over it. Now 5/9, you might think, well, this is going to be 5 times out, and it is. And I'll let you do that on the calculator to confirm it. Now, when you have a 7th on the bottom, you do get a repeating decimal, but it isn't the same number every time. So let's try 5 divided by 7, and we get, I lost it. What was the answer? It was 71428. 71428. And there were more numbers there. 285. And then after that, you see that they repeat again. So it's 7. And it repeats like that. Repeats have these 6 numbers repeat over and over again if you do out the division. See, 714285, 714285. Now, generally, we don't want to write it out in all that detail, and we would just round this off maybe 3 numbers after the decimal point. I can leave that as a 4 because the number after it is 2, and we write this abbreviation 3DP. 3 decimal places. It's been rounded off. And again, 7/15 we get just by dividing 7 divided by 15 equals, okay, so this is going to be not 0.4, and what was it, 6? And it's repeating sixes, so we can put the dot over the, just the 6, meaning the sixes repeat, not the 4s. And we might want to just round this off to not 0.467 to 3 decimal places. The last 6 I have to round up to 7 because the number after it is more than 5. Okay, so I hope this clarified things. I hope you got them all correct yourself.